Darren, my sweetness. James and I are. Wait a moment. He is still passed out under his desk. I don't know what's gotten into Mr. Cartoons. First off, he gives my sister food poisoning, and he's gotten Darren to work hardcore for a straight period of time with no breaks. He knows that is wrong, and that's very naughty. Just wait until James hears about this. I mean, no doubt at all. He is on his way. Darren still has 850 documents to finish.
850? You're missing an odd of that. That's 8,500. I heard everything that was said about inputs to cartoons. He's told everyone to give their documents to Darren.
No wonder why everyone's resting their eyes. Darren's been up for 70 hours straight, he hardly gets paid anything despite being the manager, and everyone takes advantage of him.
I don't know why this is, but it seems that Darren's unconscious. I would be too, if I ever worked for 70 hours straight.
And his documents are still piling up. He's at 11,500 documents, and no one is doing anything about it. I am going to stand up for Darren, right now.
Come on, my watermelon cupcake. Let's get Darren off to hospital. And then after that, he may rest himself.
Oh no, my poor, poor husband. I don't know how long he's been out for, but 70 straight hours would be enough to paralyze someone, energy that is. James and Millie have been working away at Darren's pile of 11,500 documents, and has evenly distributed the new ones to everyone else. Pudster Cartoons has a disciplinary hearing from me. I mean, I am Darren's wife, and no one treats him like rubbish. I couldn't care about the fact he's Darren's alter ego either. He's fed me with rancid chicken, and that had poisoned me for 4 days. He makes Darren work for 70 hours straight, and only paying him 30p an hour. Things are going to change. £21 is nowhere near enough for someone to feed even themselves, let alone a family of 2 kids, and that's excluding the 95% tax imposed on him. That leaves him with just £1.35, all the other workers get £70 an hour, tax-free, for doing nothing, whilst my husband gets just 30p an hour, and 95% of that is taxed. Ridiculous, if you ask me. I'd best make a move. I've been ranting on for too long, to realize that I need to pick the kids up from school. Now my job is to feed us with just £1.35.
I want to know why this is happening to Darren.
I don't know, sweetheart. All I know is that it's very naughty.
I can only say that it's out of our control. We're only 4, 5 and 6 years old, and we see Darren in this poor state.
Does anyone know how long he's passed out for? I can't tell myself.
I can't say either, Roscoe.
We can only see what's to come of this. All I know is that Lizzie and Roscoe S are on their way with their mum, so we'd best respect their wishes.
True. If they want us to stay, we shall. If the kids want some alone time with their dad, we will respect that too.
There you are, you three cheeky monkeys.
We were looking for you everywhere, to only realize you've been here the whole time. It's okay, Mum and Dad. Lily and Roscoe are safe with me.
Come on, Darren. We wish you a speedy recovery. We know you can pull through this.
This is bad. I can't get over how bad, though. He must have worked for a very long time to get in this state.
He has. 70 hours as a matter of fact. Sarah is doing all she can to get Darren some compensation. £150 an hour like he should get, times 70, plus another £4,500 danger pay.
As long as the maths pays off correctly, that should be £15,000. And I reckon she should add his pile of documents on there too, £1 each. So she should try for at least £26,500.
That does sound about right, considering he was still getting the documents while he had passed out. In the meantime, we need to do all we can do to look after Darren. Dad, can you take us to the shop, please?
Of course I can, my sweetness. Come on, we'll get going, straight away.
Okay, computer. Give a stat on Darren's health, please. 75%. That's good going. Shouldn't be too long now.
There you are, Millie, my darling. How are things going with Darren?
He's at 75% at this precise moment, and so I reckon another hour or two, and he should be absolutely dandy.
So I sacked Npuds to cartoons, and sued him for £35,000. That's £26,500 for Darren, and £8,500 for rendering me out of action for those 70 hours.
I must say, that he wasn't impressed.
I'm sure we can come up with something to help salvage the mess we all got into.
Wow. I would never have thought of it. I have people waiting to see me.
Why, of course, you pancake mixture. I, for one, was worried sick about you.
That's very sweet of you, my minty strawberry pancake.
I've got my daddy back, whoopee.
This is going to be swell, Dad. We have so much planned for you when you get back.
Npuds to cartoons got the sack, and we've got £35,000 to share between us.
We took care of your documents. James and I did the biggest pile, and everyone else took the brunt for it. They all got dismissed too.
That's good to know. I can start small, and work my way up.
Come on, kids. We best leave Darren to rest it up. We'll be back soon.
I'll knock us up some dinner, and I'll drive yours to you.
Thank you very much, my apple Bakewell cream.
No problem, my saucy juicy apple. So when you're ready, kids, let's go. Now.
Goodbye, Dad. See you soon.
We love you to pieces, Dad.
I'm all woken up and refreshed now, so join us in the next episode. This is where my office work is guaranteed to be more resting, calm, cool and collective. In the meantime, this is Tudster Cartoons signing off.